Children, today we are going to learn a new topic in math, that is addition of integers. Now before we go on topic, let us recall what are integers. Integers are a set of numbers, but which set of numbers? Okay. Now if I ask any child that beta tell me the numbers, so the child always starts with 1, 2, 3, 4 and he will go on. Isn't it? These set of numbers are called natural numbers. The numbers which start from 1, 2 and it will go, these set of numbers are called natural numbers. Okay. Now, you know that before 1, 0 also comes. So when we add 0 to the natural numbers, then that set of numbers is called whole numbers. So whole numbers include 0 and natural numbers. Okay. Now, but during your routine, you also come across some negative numbers. You may have heard that the temperature of Manali goes down to -2 degrees. Isn't it? Sometimes the businessman gets loss in his business of 200 rupees. So how we will denote it that? -200. So sometimes you come across negative numbers also. Okay. So these negative numbers, when we add to the set of whole numbers and natural numbers, it becomes integers. Okay. So integers are a set of numbers that include negative numbers, 0 and positive numbers. Okay. Now we are going to learn addition of integers. Again we will start with the basic. When you have learned addition for the very first time, is the teacher gave you direct sum, beta do 4 plus 3 is equal to 7? No. How you have learned? You have learned on number line. So that your concept will be clear that why 4 plus 3 is 7 only? Why I am not getting 4 plus 3 is equal to 6? Okay. So same way, now integers is new for you. It is introduced only in 6th standard. So this is for the very first time that you are learning addition of integers. So that's why again we will start with the number line. Now, in previous class, you have already learned how to denote integers on number line. Okay? Again, we will do first, I am drawing the number line. Okay? Now, you know that on number line, 0 comes in between. And on the right hand side of the 0, there are positive integers. Okay? So, I will write 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and it will go. Now, on the left hand side of the 0, negative integers come. So, here minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, minus 5, minus 6 and minus 7. Okay, so this is a number line. This is the way we denote integers on a number line. Now, before we learn addition of integers on number line, you have to keep two points in your mind that when you are adding positive integers, you have to move towards the right side of the number line. Where are the positive integers? Positive integers are on the right side of the zero. So, when you are adding positive integers, you have to move towards the right side on the number line. Integers, you have to move towards the left side on the number line. Clear? These two points you have to keep in your mind. Positive integers, when you are adding, move towards the right side. Negative integers, if you are adding, move towards the left side. Clear? Now, let us see few examples. First is 4 plus 3. Okay. Now here I am taking both integers positive. Both are positive. plus 4 plus 3. Now you know that how to do addition on number line. First number is 4. So directly we will go from 0 to 4. Okay. Now we have to add 3 in that. So now when you are adding positive integer, I told you have to move towards the right side. So 3 steps you have to go. So 1, 2, 3. So what is the answer? 7. Okay. So your answer will be 4 plus 3 is equal to 7. I'm writing here also the first sum, 4 plus 3 is equal to 7. Okay. Now the second example we will take, that is 5 plus minus 3. Now here one integer is positive and one is negative. Now let us see what we will get the sum. Now first integer is positive, that is 5. So we will go to 5. Okay, from 0 to 5. Got it? Now we have to add minus 3 in that. Now I told you when you have to add negative integer, you have to move towards the left side. Okay, so how many steps you will move? 3 steps, because you have to add minus 3. So here 1, 2, 3. So what is your answer? 2. Your answer will be 2. Okay, so 5 plus minus 3 is equal to 2. Let me write over here, 5 plus minus 3 is equal to 2. Okay. Now let us see the third example. Same I'm taking, I'm changing the sign, minus 5 plus 3. Now let us see what we will get. So here first integer is negative integer. So we will move towards the left side as it is a negative integer, minus 5. Okay, so first we will go 2 minus 5. Okay, now we have, so here first integer is negative integer, that is minus 5. So we will move towards the left side. So from 0 we will go to minus 5. Now the second integer is positive integer, that is plus 3. So you have to add plus 3. Now I told you when you have to add positive integer, you will move towards the right side. So how many steps? 3 steps you will move. So 1, 2, 3. So what answer you got? Minus 2. Okay, so let me write over here, when minus 5 plus 3 is equal to minus 2. Now we will see the fourth example. Now here I am taking minus 4 plus minus 3. Now I have taken both integers negative. Okay, so obviously we have to move towards the left side. Okay, now first is minus 4. So from 0 to minus 4. Clear? Now second is also negative. So again I have to move towards the left side only. Okay, 3 steps I have to move. So this is first, second and third. So which answer I got? Minus 7. Okay, so the fourth one is minus 4 plus minus 3 is equal to minus 7. Okay, so I have taken both here. In first example I have taken both integers positive. Here I have taken both integers negative. In this second and third one is positive, one is negative. Here also one is negative and one is positive. Now we have to learn some rules from here. So let us conclude some rules. So here you can see that now if both integers are positive, then your sum will be positive. Okay. So here, now in fourth one, I have taken both integers negative. So the sum will be negative. sign of that both integers and you have to do addition. Here both are positive, so answer will be positive. Here both are negative, so answer will be negative. And in this way, in this both sums, you have to do addition. Okay. Now let us come over here. In second and third one, you can see that one is positive and one is negative. Here also one is negative and one is positive. So when your one integer is positive and one is negative, you have to do subtraction. You don't have to do addition. You have to do subtraction. Okay. And the sign of your sum, it depends upon the sign of the greater integer. So in second one you can see that 5 plus minus 3. So here which is the greater integer? 5. So that's why your sum is, your answer is positive. And in third one you can see that out of this minus 5 and 3, this 5 is the greater integer. It is having negative sign, so that's why your sum will be negative. Your answer will be negative. Okay?